I know what you're thinking. 315 horsepower is too much for a front-wheel drive car, but we should find out. Buckle up and let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racer, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, speaking of racing and Honda Civics, I did a whole lot of that. Got all the trophies and all the championships. So I've got a love-hate relationship with Honda when it comes to performance Civics. I love it when they get it right, and I hate it when they get anything wrong. And before we get into what this new Type R is like to drive, let's have a look at it in a little more depth. Since this is the all-new Civic Type R, it's based on the recently new Civic hatchback, and there's a lot going on here. Compared to the old one, the wheelbase is longer. Of course, there's a wider track here. Chassis is stronger with more structural adhesive, spot welds, and chassis stiffening all around. The bodywork makes more downforce than before with less drag. The engine, of course, is the 2-liter turbocharged 4. It's a monoscroll turbo, makes 315 horsepower at 6,500 RPM, and it makes 310 pounds of torque from 2,600 to 4,000 RPM with a 7,000 RPM redline. It'll also run on regular fuel, but don't do that to your Type R. There is one transmission. It's a 6-speed manual. There is rev matching, which I don't know why we need it. The diff is the limited slip type. Steering is variable ratio. It's electrically assisted, of course. It's on stiffer mountings, and with the dual axis McPherson strut front suspension, it's meant to minimize torque steer, as we will find out. Rear suspension is a multi-link setup, and there are adaptive dampers. Brembo 4-piston front calipers with 2-piece 13.8-inch rotors. At the back, the rotors are 12 inches and they look like single piston calipers. And of course, there are brake cooling ducts at the front. Wheels are 19 by 9.5 in all four places, with Michelin Pilot Sport 4S's measuring 265 wide. For those who like track work, there is the Honda Log R data acquisition system. Curb weight of this new Civic Type R is about 3,200 pounds, or a little bit shy of that. And static weight distribution is 62% front, 38% rear. But on this channel, we know it's not static weight distribution that counts, it's how you use it. The first thing you notice in this new Type R are these massive seats. Love the fact that they're red, and in the back it's just black upholstery, but I love the fact that these seats are red. They are deep, deep buckets and are wonderfully supportive for the kind of work you're gonna do in your Type R. Once I'm here in this driver's seat, this is exactly what I want from a Type R. Great relationship to the pedals, to the steering wheel, to the shifter. The steering wheel is the right shape, the right size, and the pedals are perfectly laid out for heel and toe. Ergonomically, this is all new Civic. There's nothing new here in that regard, except for a couple of Type R touches. We do have the plus R drive mode button, and of course there are other drive modes, including a custom configurable one, which we will talk about in a little bit. In terms of spaciousness, this is pretty much Civic hatchback, and the great news is, with the longer wheelbase of this new Civic, there's tons of room in the back seat. So even if I sit behind myself in the seating position, I am ridiculously comfortable, and there's tons of space and a decent amount of headroom, both in this row, this first row, and the second row, and under the hatch. It is voluminous. You can put all kinds of things in there, and if you need, the seats split and fold, so you can put all kinds of large objects in here, like I would, golf clubs, snowboards, bicycles, whatever the case is. This is relatively quick, especially for a front drive car. At low speeds, yes, you can overtax those front tires. These Michelin Pilot Sports do a fantastic job of every single task you ask of them. But in terms of putting 315 horsepower down, lower speeds, it's a little bit of a challenge, but once you're on the move, no trouble at all. Honda says this will do 0 to 60 in a tick over 5 seconds. I really don't want to abuse this car to test that. On top of that, they also say it'll do about 170 miles an hour, and that is something I'm willing to test on a racetrack somewhere. The great thing about the front end is it's very well resolved in terms of having a limited slip diff and the suspension geometry, and of course those tires help, which I always come back to. But In practice, what that means is torque steer is at a minimum, and I haven't experienced any at all, and that is a delight. This thing puts down power just wonderfully for a front-wheel drive car, and that's a lot of power and a lot of torque that you're asking to be put down through those front tires. I'm very impressed at how well-resolved this Type R is. On the other hand, I might have a little bit of experience with high-performance front-wheel drive race cars, so I might be a little bit more disciplined with the throttle and the steering, but if you're not, the suspension geometry and the limited slip diff and the tires might resolve some of the issues, but I do recommend going to a high-performance driving school. One thing that is going on with this engine is the fakey fake sounds, which I'm really not a fan of. It is switchable, as is the rev matching, and the reason I have it on right now is so we can hear that, and I do want to talk about rev matching. The pedals are placed perfectly, and if you know how to heel and toe, you don't need rev matching, although I will say that the rev matching is exceptionally well refined. Some drivers haven't been fortunate to learn how to heel and toe. Well, good news, we have the definitive episode on how to learn how to heel and toe on this channel. Links here, links below, and I'll teach you how to heel and toe. Love the shift linkage, and I love the shifter. For a front-wheel drive car, this is basically perfection. Does an excellent job, and I'm never missing a shift. It is just fantastic, and Honda has done an excellent job with this Type R. There are a bunch of different drive modes that do have an impact on the dynamics of this Type R, and the one that I'm interested in is the custom one, because you can set throttle response, steering, and damping to your liking, and then the two that I really don't care for, which is the sound augmentation, or whatever Honda calls it, as well as rev matching. Both of those, I can switch them off, and I'm very, very happy. We do have to talk about steering a little, because it is quite good here, and we did talk about it in terms of how they designed the system, but in practice, what it's got is a very strong on-center feel, and then on top of that, it has the right amount of heft. Then what is meaningful to drivers like us is that it is very, very precise and, of course, responsive. Those Michelin Pilot Sports definitely help the responsiveness of this system, but I'm very happy with the steering in this Type R, and there's a decent amount of feel and feedback. If you're paying attention and listening to the chassis and listening to what the tires are doing, you can definitely tell what's going on here. The chassis does a good job communicating, and it does so at the front end a little bit more than I was expecting, especially with a car with electrically assisted power steering. Brakes are incredibly powerful. I'm very, very happy with the brakes. Obviously, a lot of credit due to the four-piston front Brembo calipers and the two-piece rotors. These brakes are just fantastic. And on top of that, they've done a great job refining them. I have millimeter control with the brakes. I can adjust the attitude of this car with that brake pedal so easily. This is just a incredibly well-resolved front-wheel drive car from a dynamic standpoint, but the fact that I can do that and adjust the attitude of the car with the brake pedal is just icing on the cake. Dynamically, this is a Type R, so a firmer ride is expected, and then what that gives you is incredibly minimal body roll. There's very, very little body roll in this Type R. I'm just blown away at how flat this corners. And then on top of that, these adaptive dampers, they're not super sophisticated. They are the adaptive type, not a conventional kind. They do a fantastic job of body and wheel control up to the most roughest of road surfaces. I happen to choose a very rough road that we were to drive on today and shoot a little bit of this footage, and these dampers were a little bit taxed. Now, the road was incredibly bad, and on our average roads in this Toronto area, these dampers do a fine job. They're not punishing by any stretch of the imagination. It's just a firm ride, as you'd expect from a Type R. I just love that. This Type R is fantastic. Love putting the power down, and that's really never a problem. But when you are playing with this in the corners, it is an incredibly well-balanced package. The handling balance is very much near neutral. This is one of the most neutral platforms, front-wheel drive platforms, that I have ever driven. I can balance this, like I said, on the brake pedal as well as on the throttle. I can adjust the attitude with both of those, as well as the steering, and all three of those systems, the steering, the braking, the throttle, work in harmony, and I can really play with this. We do talk about weight distribution on this channel, and static weight distribution is kind of a useless specification because it's all about how you use it, and this Type R lets you use this. Even though statically there's a lot of weight on the nose of the car, the way this chassis is balanced is just incredible. It is a delight to drive at its limits. Absolutely a blast. If anyone is going to complain about the ride quality of your Type R, it might be your spouse or your kids. This does ride on the firm side, and in an area like where I live in the Toronto area where the roads are just generally crap, they might complain, but you know you're going to be able to enjoy the suspension when you can throw this through the corners with all the confidence in the world. See, this is fun. How you can hustle this Type R so easy. Ah, love it. Got tremendous confidence in this Type R. How do you spec yours? Well, this is a very easy question to answer because the Civic Type R only comes one way, with the exception of the color of paint you'd like. As tested, this is just shy of $44,000 in the US, or a little over $50,000 here in Canada. In the US, you've got five color choices. It's Rally Red, or is it Rallier Red? Black Pearl, Championship White, Sonic Gray, or Boost Blue Pearl. In Canada, there are only three color choices. It's red, gray, or the only appropriate choice for a Honda Civic Type R, Championship White. My verdict? Well, we often talk about fuel consumption in this segment, and since we have talked about the new Civic in previous episodes, I think I'm getting about 20 miles per gallon, but it really doesn't matter to me. This new Civic Type R is absolutely a blast to drive. As for 315 horses being too much for this new Civic Type R, well, if you drive like an absolute maniac at low speeds, sure, it might be a problem from time to time, but if you have some experience, know what you're doing, you're going to be able to exploit all 315 horses that this engine makes. And as for the overall package of this new Civic Type R, this might be the best front-wheel drive performance car we're going to see in our lifetimes. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this all-new 2023 Honda Civic Type R. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, especially Honda Civic Type R's.